Good afternoon, class. My name is Mr. Dennis F. Pineda, and I will be your teacher in organic agriculture. Okay, so before we proceed to our discussion this afternoon, I will start with a prayer. Okay, I will ask everyone to put yourselves in the presence of the Lord. Dear Lord, thank you for this wonderful day that you have given us. Give us the wisdom so that we could understand our discussion this afternoon. Give us good health and provision so we could continue the every day of our lives. Bless us everyone in the name of our Lord Jesus. Amen. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Okay, so I will ask Mr. Tapayan to please check the attendance.
All of my classmates are present, sir.
Okay, so thank you, Mr. Tapayan. So we will proceed first. We're going to discuss about the rules in our session this afternoon. So if the session has been started, please mute your device so that we could not interfere with the unnecessary noise. Okay, so refrain from moving around when session is started. Okay, so if you have any questions, just show me your hands so that I could entertain your questions. And if you have some other question, please send it to our group chat. Okay, so does everybody is connected already in our group chat? Okay, so I guess everyone is already connected with our group chat because no one is responding. Okay, so we will proceed to our discussion this afternoon. So we will first, I will show you the objectives of our discussion this afternoon. Okay, so at the end of this discussion, I am hoping that everyone will understand the concept of organic concoction. Okay, then you're going to value the importance of organic concoction in natural farming. Okay, so you're going to select the appropriate organic concoction for a certain plant's deformities and deficiency. Okay, so anybody has the question? Okay, so before I will start this one, I'm going to show you some pictures, and I wanted you to keep in your mind about your observation in these pictures. Okay, so I'm going to show first our first picture. Okay, so this is our first picture. So I want you to internalize what's wrong with this picture. Then I'm going to ask you, after this one, I'm going to ask you about your observation in these pictures. Okay, so the picture number two is this one. Okay, so do you have already in your mind? The third picture is this one. All right, so the last picture is this one. Okay, so the question is, what do you observe with these following pictures? Okay, so anybody? Anybody from the class could give me some observation in these pictures?
The plants has many insects, sir.
Okay, very good. So you observe that the plants have insects, and some other has deformities, deficiencies, and malnutrition. Okay, so what do you think this plant needs?
And pesticide.
All right, so they need pesticides.
Yes. They need fertilizer, sir.
Yes. Okay, so they need fertilizers and pesticides. Okay, so another question. Can we use the commercial or synthetic pesticides and fertilizer to address this problem? Can we use the synthetic pesticides and fertilizer?
Yes, sir.
I think we will not going to use that one. Okay, because we are going to use the organic approach. So we are not going to use the synthetic and commercial fertilizer and pesticides on this one. So since we are going to use the organic approach, what are we going to use to substitute the use of this organic, this commercial and synthetic fertilizers and pesticides? Does anyone have any idea what are we going to use to replace or to substitute the use of organic and commercial pesticides? Okay, so we're going to use concoction. Okay, so we're going to use organic concoction to replace or substitute the use of commercial and synthetic fertilizers and pesticides. Does anyone has any idea about what concoction is? Have you heard this word before?
No, sir.
All right. So since everyone has no idea about the organic concoction, so we're going to discuss it right now. What is an organic concoction? Okay. So by definition, organic concoction is the combination of various ingredients, usually herbs, spices, condiments, powdery substances, mineral mixed up together, means dissolved or macerated into liquid. So it means that we're going to extract some needed nutrients from a certain plants materials to be used to replace the use of our commercial pesticides and fertilizer. Okay, so the organic concoction is the heart of organic farming. Why? Because without organic concoction, organic farming is impossible, because plants need fertilizers and pesticides and ameliorants in order to survive. So since we are not using already the commercial, so the plants will going to need some of those condiments, some of those fertilizers and pesticides in order to survive. Okay, so it is that's why it is called as the heart of organic farming. Okay, so the organic concoction is used to replace the commercial and fertilizers and pesticides. Okay, so it is used to replace them. Okay, so how can we make a organic concoction? Can we buy it? Technically, no. So we were going to create our own organic concoction. So it is homemade or school made, or it cannot be bought any commercial establishment. Okay, so in making the organic concoction, there are a standard or general procedure in making an organic concoction. Okay, so first is we're going to chop the substrate or the raw materials into the desired thickness according to the type of concoction. So every type of concoction has the desired thickness of its raw material when making it into concoction. Okay, so we're going to add molasses to the chopped substrate to attract microorganism in the ratio according to the type of concoction. Okay, so why do we need to put molasses? Molasses is the food of microorganism. So it will going to attract the microorganism in order to extract all the needed nutrients that you want in making the organic concoction. Okay, so let the mixture undergo a fermentation. So we let the microorganism to ferment the mixture of molasses and our substrate to extract the desired elements that we going to extract from the certain plants to make our specific concoction. Okay, so the fermentation process has different duration according to its type. Okay, so after the recommended duration of its fermentation, we're going to separate the liquid from the sludge. So the sludge means the solid parts of the fermentation result. Okay, so we're going to separate the liquid from the solid. Then the liquid one, we're going to use it and mix with water, and we're going to apply it in the plants as a foliar. All right, so that is the general procedure in making the organic concoction. Okay, so there are types of concoction. So we have first is the IMO, the indigenous microorganism. So the use of IMO is to speed up the decomposition process and suppress the soil-borne diseases because IMO is a microorganism. So we're going to culture the microorganism and use it for the farming consumption. Okay, so number two is the FPG or the fermented plant juice. So the use of FPG is a growth enhancer for both plants and animals. So number three, we have the fermented fruit juice or the FFJ as our natural taste enhancer and a source of potassium. All right, so the fourth is the FAA or fish amino acid as a source of nitrogen and amino acids for our animals. Then we have the calpos. The calpos is a soil neutralizer, so a source of calcium for both plants and animals. So it is extracted from a bone or an eggshell. Okay, so the last one is the OHN or Oriental Herbal Nutrients. So we have two types of OHN, the OHN1 as for animal use as immune system booster, and the OHN2 for plant use as insect repellents and natural fungicide. Okay, so that is the six type of concoction that we're going to make in the next days. All right, so activity time. All right, so are you ready with our activity?
Yes, sir.
All right, so using the same pictures I showed you earlier, so I am asking you, since you have already in your mind about your observation on those following pictures, so I am asking you to make a recommendation or suggest a appropriate concoction to address those plant deformities and deficiencies. Okay, so I'm going to show you the first picture. Okay, so what concoction does this plant needs?
It needs fertilizer, sir.
All right, so this plant, you see there is a problem in growing here. So we observe that the plants are already some aged already, but it lacks of growth. So we're going to use the FPG in here. So because FPG is a growth enhancer, so we're going to apply FPG to enhance the growth. All right, so let's proceed to our next picture. What concoction this plant needs?
It needs nutrients, sir.
Okay, so it really need nutrients because you see the yellowing of the leaves. So what kind of nutrients we need to address the yellowing of leaves? So we are going to use it needs nitrogen. All right, so it needs nitrogen to address the yellowing of leaves. So our source of nitrogen in concoction is the FAA, okay, the fish amino acid. So going to apply the FAA here to address the yellowing of the leaves. Okay, so the third picture is this one. So what concoction does this plant needs?
It needs spray pesticide, sir.
All right, so I guess your idea is good, but you see, this problem is a malnutrition, so micro and macronutrients deficiency. So it needs some calcium, it needs some phosphorus. So I think the best concoction we can use here is calpos as a source of calcium, and then FFG as a source for potassium. Okay, so the last picture is this one. So what concoction does this plant needs?
It's need insecticide, sir.
All right, so yeah, it really needs an insecticide, but in the organic approach, we don't need to destroy or destroy the population of a certain insect, whether beneficial or harmful. We just need to repel this one. So we're going to use the OHN2 as an insect repellent to repel this caterpillar from our plants. All right, so very good to your answers. So, okay, so let's proceed to our next activity. Okay, so based on our discussion about the concoction, So I am asking you to write some short essay about what have you learned regarding the organic concoction and how can it help our farmer who want to engage in organic farming. Okay, so just send your essay to my Gmail account. Okay, so I just put there in our screen. So just send there. I will give you 15 minutes to complete your to write your short essay. Okay, so we will not going to finish this discussion today without sending your essay first. Okay, so I will give you 15 minutes to make your essay. Okay, I think the 15 minutes is already it's already end. Okay, so I am waiting for the confirmation here in my email ad. Okay, so everybody is sending already, so I am receiving already lots of email. So I will going to coincide this with your attendance right now. So I am still waiting for another to send. Okay, so I think 80% already sending their emails right now. Okay, so there's still 4 students that haven't yet sent their email. Okay. All right. So I think everyone has already already sent their essay. So any follow-up questions will be asked to our group chat. So we have our group. Remember that everyone, I invite you to be part of the group chat. So our discussion started. So I am already asking you, does everyone haven't yet connected with our group chat? So any questions after this discussion, I'm going to entertain it through our group chat. So don't hesitate to send your question regarding our discussion this afternoon. All right, so you may now send any question, you may now send it to our group chat immediately. Okay, so for your assignment, okay, so this is for tomorrow. So we'll also conduct a online tutorial about making the IMO concoction. So we have discussed already about the IMO. We have a brief discussion about the IMO. So tomorrow we're going to discuss a broad or a deeper discussion about the IMO concoction. So you're going to prepare the following materials at your home. Okay, so you're going to prepare first the cooked rice. Okay, 3 cup standard serving. So based on the canteen in your canteen or in the carinderia at your respective barangay. Okay, so also bring a wooden container. So you mix a wooden box or you can use the bamboo bush. No, you can like a chicken feederer, you know, like that appearance. So you can prepare that one for our IMO concoction making. Okay, then you have to prepare a plastic container. So much better, it should have a cover. So a small pail is enough already. So then you are going to purchase 1 liter of molasses. No, you can buy it in Kalinan. So you can buy it at the producer, the agricultural supplier in Kalinan. So you can buy it. So it should be 1 liter because we're going to use it on the next discussion of our IMO making. Okay, so you need also a weighing scale and a graduated cylinder to check the quantity of our raw materials is correct. Okay, so just prepare also Manila paper, a rubber strip or rubber bands is enough already. So just prepare, I think, 10 rubber bands to cover our concoction in our to secure the cover of our container. Okay, so and finally a marker. Okay, so we're going to prepare this one for tomorrow's discussion so that we can continue to our next next concoction. Okay. So any more questions? You may raise your hands.
No, sir.
Okay. So. Okay, thank you. So I think everybody has already understood our discussion this afternoon. Okay, so thank you very much for this wonderful discussion with you all. Okay, so thank you and God bless. Okay, see you tomorrow, class.
See you, sir. Bye-bye, sir.
Okay, thank you.